Hello, everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good day, and welcome back to Car Mechanics Simulator, where today we're having another super long special because I asked you in the previous Car Mechanics Simulator if you wanted to see me rebuild this car to leave 1,000 likes, and you guys did once again. So here we are with another long special, but this isn't going to be like the other one, because in the other one, I pretty much did it almost completely unedited, and there were some bits that really dragged on and were a bit boring, so that's why I'm not going to have any of the part buying stuff in this video. I'm going to sort of skip past that bit. So I'm going to test this car, I'm going to tear everything out of it, and then we're going to skip the whole buying and fixing process. And then I'm just going to put everything back together again. So here we are. And the reason why I'm doing this is I'm not going to have a sort of on a regular occasion of doing full proper rebuilds with this game. However, I have two more codes to give away for you to get this DLC. If you already have the standard, you have to have the standard game, I should point out. This code will be for the DLC, the Mercedes DLC for this game. So if you would like to be in with a chance to win, I will be asking five questions throughout this video. So you have to watch the whole video, find where the questions are, and answer them in one single comment. This is where you guys kind of got confused with the previous one. I saw that you would like answer one question per comment. Do not do that. If you are only going to watch part of the video and see two comments, there's no point in answering them because you won't be entered in the quiz. It's the people who answer all five questions throughout the video. And you put that into one single comment, like once you've watched the end of the video, you can then put them all together and you will be entered in to win. I will announce winners in about a week's time after this video has gone live. So first of all, by the way, there are some comments and questions on the screen right about now. You can also follow me on Twitter at figure8, links in the description below. What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to take this over to the old factory test track because we need to find out the conditions of all of our parts. So let's go in here. And let's go to the test track. Okay, here we go. Let's see how we do. Not too bad. Not too bad. Okay. Whoa! We actually completely span out there. The thing is, I can't tell whether it's the handling, whether it's the... I just don't know what. I don't know whether it's the handling of this game or the fact that this car is completely damaged. I don't know what it is, but the handling on these things is always absolutely awful. And even if we hit things, it doesn't have any sort of damage in this game, so... which should be pretty fine. Oh god, this is terrible. Right, here we go. Over the little bumpy bumps. Over here. And then brake to finish. We actually jumped then. That was crazy. And jumped to finish. And now we're going to see how terrible the condition of our parts are. And here is the result. Lots of terrible things that need to be fixed. So now that we've done that, we need to take this over to the test path so we can test the brakes and the suspension. So let's go in here. And whilst we do this, I figure it's time to give the first question out. And don't forget, guys, don't actually, like, put the question in the comments. I know what I'm asking, so just number it and put the answer. You don't need to put in any of that sort of stuff. Right, press and hold brake. Here we go. Was that good? Move rear wheels on. That was terrible. Look at that. They should be at 100 each. And they're at, like, 20, which is just awful. So the first question is... Ooh, what should the first question be? First question, okay, I'm going to have this the same as the other video. The first question is, do you have Car Mechanic Simulator? And the second question is going to be, do you have this DLC? I think there are important questions that you need to answer for me to know whether you should be within the chance to win it. Because if you don't have this game and you don't have any chances of buying this game, then the DLC is no good for you. And if you have the DLC, why are you entering? Maybe it's for a friend. I don't know. Maybe you'd have to point that out if you do. And there we go. Test complete. If you're wondering, oh, there we go. Here's our results. If you're wondering why I'm doing this whole sort of five questions throughout the video thing, it's because I want the people that are entering to be properly interested. And if you're just sort of passing through, I've had this problem with competitions in the past that a lot of people just pass through. They don't really care. They enter it. And then you go to message them and they never answer you back. I've got codes for games that I've actually bought for people to win and they never claim them. So I want to make sure that you guys are really interested, and I think a pretty good way of letting me know that you're interested is by watching the video. I think that is a pretty good way of letting me know. So that's why I'm having that. And also, I'm pretty much an evil genius, and obviously if you watch the video, I'm going to have better audience retention. Oh, that was too many YouTube secrets. Okay, now it's time to rip this thing apart. Let's stick it on the lifter, and let's start ripping everything out. So first of all, I'm going to take off the hood once it's moved up. There we go. Take that off. And now we just take everything apart. Should we go underneath first? I feel like we should go underneath first. Okay, right. Let's first start by taking off all of the wheels. Here we go. This is where I'm now going to tone it down. At the start, it was sort of like, yeah, new video. Now it's like, okay, now let's calm down before my voice gets really bad and my throat hurts. Here we are. Take this off. Here we go. Looking pretty. Ooh, that's different. Oh, that came out different to the other one. That's interesting. Rear coil spring rear drive axle. This looks very similar to how my suspension is on my car, actually. Ah, interesting. What I'm going to have to try and do is try to retain some sort of information as I do this thing, because I really just forgot everything I did with the previous video. There we go. We have the spring cap. This is pretty interesting. Leaf spring U-bolt. I'm not sure if mine is a leaf spring. I didn't think it was. But it is one, like, fully joined thing with a suspension at both ends. But I didn't think that was actually a leaf spring. I don't know. Oh, we're taking the wheel off from this angle. Sure, why not? There we go. Can we do that and look around? Ooh, there we go. Let's take it off from this end. Here we go. Let's take the caliper off. Then the pads. Then the discs. Then the solid rear drive axle. Take that off. The rear axle knuckle housing. And now we're down to this. Okay, rear spring, spring cap, leaf spring U-bolt. Is that on both sides that we have to do that? Oh, yeah, we do. Both sides. Okay. Pardon me for burping there. And around on the other side, if I can click round. There we go. Leaf spring U-bolt. That's all sort of rusty looking. Now, I don't think we just ripped the axle off. Oh, we have to go from underneath. So we have to take off the solid axle control arm. Nope, the leaf spring plate first, then, no, maybe not the control arm. Oh, wait, rubber bushings, of course. So one of the things I noticed with my car, which has a very similar setup, is when you really go hard around corners, because it doesn't have independent rear suspension, like, the whole thing sort of tilts, and it means that when you're sort of really hard cornering, your wheels sort of dig in at an angle. It's really hard to explain. I'd have to, like, show my hands. But it sort of makes, like, the wheels dig in and then lift up on the other side because they aren't independent rear suspension. My car has a lot of oversteer for a front-wheel drive car. If it's really wet, I guess the tyres are sort of prone to that as well, part of the reason why it happens. But in certain conditions, my car just spins out completely. I've spun my car out quite a few times. Most of the time, I manage to hold it, but sometimes I just lose my talent. I think that's a better way of saying it. Something just goes wrong and my car just spins out and I'm not able to recover. I guess it's when it's front wheel drive, it snaps at you. Oh, we have to go for that from the engine bay. It's sort of just like, as soon as you get grip again on the front, it just sort of, snaps back. I think it would be a lot easier to control a oversteer with a rear wheel drive car, I feel, than the front wheel drive. Especially as it's got a really short wheelbase. My car just sort of snaps back as soon as it's got grip again. And you can sort of like, of course, it's called like a tank slapper, I think people call it. Where it would suddenly like spin and they go around to the other side. I haven't done a tank slapper yet, but I feel like I'm very close to doing it one day. I'm sure I'll let you guys know. What have we got to take off now? Okay, upper suspension arm. There we go. Lots of waffling in this video, I know. It's very hard, as I've said in the previous video, it's very hard to know what to talk about sometimes. It's always talk about the game. That's normally what it is, but then I don't know. Some of this stuff I don't really know what I'm doing. I'm just sort of taking bits off. Can we take this bit off yet? No, we have to take off that on both sides. And take off the outer tie rod. Of course. Now we can take that off. There we go. And I guess now the same on the other side. Let's take off the inner tie rod as well. Rubber bushings. Front sway bar we don't take off yet. What else can we take off that's there? Steering rack, we can't because of the other side. Okay, let's go around to the other side. Take this wheel off. There we go. And of course, if you didn't know and you didn't watch the previous video, I do have all of these things upgraded. That's why I have fast unbolting and all that sort of stuff and a tablet and all these sort of things. I have made sure. You might notice my account balance and experience is really high. It's, I wouldn't say it's a hacked account. It's a special code that was given to me by the developers in order for me to make videos without having to play the game. Because I played this game for quite a bit and I realized that, wow, I'm going to have to play this game a hell of a lot if I want to do videos on it. And obviously, for the sake of just doing the videos, I want to just push out the content. And ignore the fact that you need to earn credit. But yes, this game does take quite a lot of time and effort if you want to get this far, especially with cars like this, because this is a pretty expensive car to buy at auction compared to something like the Melucci or whatever they're called, which is like that Fiat, not Fiat 500, it's like a Fiat 124, 126, something like that. Yeah, they're pretty cheap. But if you get to something like this, I think I paid about 50,000 at auction for this thing, or something close to that. So you'd have to do a lot of work if you wanted to modify one of these or rebuild one of these. Right, let's take out these rear bushings. These aren't rear bushings, they're just normal bushings. Take out the tie rod, sway bar, steering rack. Why not the crossmember yet? I guess, is that because the engine's here? Take out the oil filter. Didn't think about spilling oil, but it's not going to spill oil for some reason. Why can't I take that off? What am I missing here? Is this going to have to be like, once we've taken the engine out, then we can take the crossmember out? That might be why. I think that makes sense. Right, here we go. Let's pop this thing down and take the engine out. And this is a weird engine. Let's take out the radiator first of all. Radiator fan. This looks very simple though, actually. Incredibly simple compared to the last one. And the last one was pretty simple compared to some of the others. This is actually really simple. So we go for that one. Serpentine belt. Then the crankshaft pulley. Then what else do we get? The alternator we could take off now, I guess. Here we go. And timing cover. This is really... We're taking this out really quickly. This is a really simple setup, which is pretty nice. I think that's why I would recommend, if you were to get, if you're like looking for a new car right now, or you're looking for your first car perhaps, get an older car. I mean, some of the things that I learned on my Golf, I know I said I didn't do much on my Golf, but I still learned something about working on cars. I learned that I hated it, that's what I learned, but I learned that much. And it was so much easier working on that car. If I was to try and take out the interior of something like my dad's car, he's got like a modern Honda Accord. Comparing that to like ripping the interior out and re-putting it in an old Mark II Golf, you can actually do that. Even me, as someone who is an idiot, I can do that. And I think that getting an older car to learn on is just such a cool thing, especially as driving is just like my car doesn't have ABS, my car doesn't have power steering. And I love that. I really would recommend having that as your first car without those sort of aids. It teaches you a lot about driving. You don't have to rely on all these sort of modern technologies. Although most cars aren't going to have them now, I think it's still a good thing to learn without it. I think it would improve your driving skills, I think. Let me know what you think in the comment section below, actually. Do you agree with me? Do you think that you should get an older car and learn with something that's more basic first? I don't know. That's just my thoughts. So let's take that off. This is going super, super quick. So let's take off the... Nope, we're going to have to take off next. Let's just go for the gearbox. We're going to have to go from under the car for that one. Is there anything we could take off from here? Oh, yes, look. Spark plugs. Spark plugs out. Oh, that's nice and easy. Look how quick that was to take out. There we go. And we need to take out the camshaft, the cam gear, the timing belt, which needs to take off that timing chain sprocket. Is that just one sprocket for the entire car? There was like five in the other one. Oh, there we go. There's two. What else is there? Is that it? There we go. That was it. Two. Cam gear off. Camshaft off. Rocker arms off. This is fantastic. We're blitzing this right now. We're 16 minutes into this video. That's fantastic. And I'm sure I've probably cut some of this out already. Wow. Okay, yeah. I know that I really wanted to know what you guys thought about the longer video. But to be honest, most of you just answered the questions and you didn't really answer that. So I'm not still entirely sure what you think of the longer video thing. But if you could let me know, maybe you could have an extra comment letting me know what you think about that. I'd be really curious to know. Right, now it's time to take out the massive amount of pistons in... Oh, no, maybe not. We're going to have to take out first. Oh, here we go. Mechanical fuel injection. Oh, there we go. The fuel injection's here. That's interesting. Right, there's that off. There's that off. Now we take the pistons out, I guess. No? What are we missing? What are we missing? Maybe... Oh, okay, maybe we have to take this stuff off underneath. Okay, let's lift this. Okay, here we go. Can we take the... Okay, we can't take the crossmember out yet. Oil pan, we can, though. We can take the oil pan out. Here we go. Hopefully we won't spill oil on the floor. There we go. And take our starter off, which... Oh, I have to get from the engine bay. Oh, that's annoying. Right. Why is it... It's just so up and down with this thing. Look at the way this engine sat. That's really weird. I've never seen an engine like that before. This just shows you how much I know about engines. Right, and back under the car. Oh, God. Up and down. Up and down. And, whoop, hold on there. I want to get over here. Can you hang on? Oh, it wants to do the exhaust, that's why. I want to do the engine. There we go. Take the gearbox off. Nice and simple. Really nice and simple. Really weird engine, but nice and simple nonetheless. Take that off. Pressure plate, which I don't think even a bad clutch would have rust on it. That is pretty intense. There we go. There's the clutch plate. Flywheel. And then we can't take the crankshaft off until what? Pistons first, I guess? Wasn't there something else we had to take out? Oh, God. Let's just check the pistons first. Okay, now let's see. Pistons? Yeah, there we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That makes this an inline 6, right? Right? I'm not too dumb. I think that's right. Some of these things, I think I do know them, but as soon as I say them, I'm thinking, oh, maybe I'm wrong. Every time I say something I think I'm right, someone in the comment section says, no, you're an idiot. It's this way. You've done it wrong. You're an idiot. So I don't know. I sort of doubt everything I say these days. Right, so before that, we need the crankshaft bearing caps off. There we go. There's another one there. And another one there. And another one there. And one more left. Right here. There we go. Let's take our crankshaft off. Oh, look at this. What's left? Is that just it? Just the engine block, right? Can we take the... I don't think we can take that off yet, can we? No, we're going to have to take the block out first. This is amazing. We've almost completely ripped it out in about 20 minutes, which is not too bad. There we go. Oh, look, that's what I was missing. One freaking rubber bushing, you moron. You moron. Oh, could have taken it out ages ago. Clearly, we didn't need to take that out. I just couldn't see the bearing. There we go. Or bushing, rather. There we go. Bushing out. Cross member out. Oh, hang on. We've got a floating fuel filter here. What's up with that? Oh my god. We've just got a floating fuel filter in here. And that is everything. Apart from the battery. Let's just take the battery out then. There we go. Battery out. No. Oh, there we go. Battery out. And that is it done. There is our inventory. There is all the stuff to fix. Right. So now, what I'm just going to do is I'm just going to spam repair all this sort of stuff. I'm sure there's going to be... we can already hear stuff that's broken. Let's go super... Oh, here we go. I keep accidentally clicking off this thing. Here we go. I go too quick. So much stuff breaking. So much stuff to buy. Not too bad. Chance of repair for most of this stuff is 90%. That's pretty cool. Obviously, depending on what your stats are, depends on how good your chances of repair are. So I am able to repair a lot more things than perhaps someone who's just starting out in this game. Again, that's what you have to spend your experience points on. Here we go. Oh my god, there's still so much. I'm going to skip all of this. And, oh, actually, we're getting close. Maybe we can see. Oh, speeding up, speeding up. Here we go. Everything almost done. And here we go. Fixing these two and done. Let's see. Oh my god, look at this lot. This is why it's going to take ages. And that is why I'm about to skip this bit. So I'm going to buy all of these parts. And then we're going to come back. And we're going to put everything back together again. And here we are with everything completely fixed and rebought. It just takes so much time. It's so boring. There really needs to be something in this game that just allows you to, I don't know, make a shopping list or something. Like, you could probably, like, tick things off here. Then when you go on to here, you'd have, like, a list on the left. Or maybe you could select things from here and then you could, like, rebuy or buy another one of or replace or... something like that. That would be really useful because it's really annoying having to... Well, normally I like set it by name, or not condition, I set it by name, and then I have to go around and just go alphabetically through and through, and it's a big massive pain. But now everything's bought, we can now put everything back together. So I'm going to start underneath. I think this is... I want to try and do it in some sort of order and not just sort of like chucking bits around where I can. I want to get this all sort of right, so let's start with here. Here we go. First thing is coil spring rear drive axle, and yeah, I still don't know about that. Is that, that's the differential, right? Mind you, no, this would be, is this real, I think this is rear wheel drive, so that's the differential, I assume. We're gonna learn about all these things. Oh, man. I don't want to, like, end up sounding like a complete noob when I make these things. I would like to sound sort of confident, like, yeah, I know what I'm talking about. But I don't want to pretend to know what I'm talking about, because that's lame. At least I'm acknowledging the fact that I don't know about these things. I think that's a good thing, I feel. Right, there's our suspension. This is nice and simple, really is. What I want to know is, in this setup, how would you lower a car? Would you just have to get shorter shocks and shorter springs? I mean, these springs are pretty short as they are. I don't really know. I know that there's apparently, when you have leaf spring suspension, you can like flip the springs and it makes it lower or something. I don't really get that, but I'd really like to know, because my car has a very similar setup and I would like to lower it, you know. Although, to be honest, actually, talking about my car, one of the things that I thought when I bought that car was, yeah, I'm going to put loads of parts on it, I'm going to lower it, make it really cool, do it up, which is the thing that people think about with every car that they buy, I feel. They always look at that car and think, yeah, I could do so much cool stuff to that car. And then when I got it, I thought, well, hang on, it's cheap, it's old, it's just a runabout car. I bought that car for 500 quid, and you think, is it really worth putting all that money into it? And because of that, I've not really done anything to my car apart from sticking some wheels on it, which then got ruined when I drove over a pothole that was hidden inside a speed bump. So since then, I've not actually done anything to my car, modifying-wise, because I just felt it just wasn't worth it. I think you really have to pick your battles with cars, and trying to modify a 500 quid car that's mostly like a runabout, I don't think that's worth it. Is there anything else to add on this side? I don't want to add the wheels, because that feels like I've completed that side, but I feel like there should be more. Let's move this over here. I'll tell you what, this camera thing is quite awkward. There we go. Stick that on there. That on there. That on there. This really is nice and simple on the back. Look, I think it's a lot simpler than having it with all the individual suspension stuff like we have on the... Oh, did I just take that out? No, I put that in. Okay. I'm starting to lose where I am with this. It's the camera thing. It's just never... I would like it to focus on a bit that's not done, if that makes sense. Oh yeah, I was looking through the updates for this game, and apparently there is an expert mode coming, where when you take it apart, when you take it all apart, and it has like the red bit that says, no, you can't take this bit off because you got to take this bit off first, that's all hidden, and a bunch of other things as well, like it doesn't even highlight the bolts, you just have to find where the bolts are yourself. And what I should try and do is, when that comes out, I think I might attempt to do a video where I try to rebuild a car or something. That might be a really bad idea, and it might take me a long time, but I feel like it's a good challenge. So I think for a challenge video, I may as well do it. I think that's everything on that side. I think that is everything. So let's just put the wheels back on. There we go, and round to this side. There we go, wheel back on. Wow, that's the rear suspension and brakes done. Already. Right, what else have we got? We got exhaust. We need to do that. So let's go with the back box. In fact, actually, let's not put the exhaust on because there is no engine to attach to. So I'm not going to do that yet. I'm going to leave that till later. Right, here we go. So back to the front then. Suspension again. Here we go. Oh, we can actually do all the bottom of the engine and stuff from this way, of course. Right, I guess. Oh, actually, no, it does say from engine bay. Why does that highlight that if you can't even put it in from that angle? Oh, well. Right, okay. Well, first things first, cross member. And, I was hoping... Oh, there we go. We had to do it from the top. That's why. Bushings go from the top, not the bottom. Stick all of our four rubber bushings in. There we go. Other side, if we can. Trying to get that to focus. That's good. And where's the last one? There she is. Nicely done. And why does this not attach? We can have that. That's the front sway bar. We put that on. Then we have the steering rack goes on. Right. What's the next bit? I don't want it. Look, this looks like it's hovering. And it makes me feel like I don't want to put it on. I guess that's the next bit. That bit there. Oh, solid. We're going to have to stick on this floating bit to put the rest of it on. That's a bit weird. Why does it do it that way? That doesn't feel right. Okay, outer tie rod on. This is doing pretty well. And here's our suspension here. Shock absorber. That's at a funny angle, actually. Why is that? That seems weird to me. Why is that at a weird angle? Is that just because it's like... Oh, I guess it's a classic car. You can't really explain it. There's probably something in there that's... I don't know. Like, even the engine's tilted at a funny angle. I guess that's not the weirdest thing about this car. Why is that, though? If anyone knows about these sort of things, I'm sure many of you are more knowledgeable about engines than I am. Feel free to let me know in the comment section below and teach me. That would be good. Right, here we go. On to these vented brake pads. Brake discs, rather. These are the brake pads. I got confused with what I was saying. Brake calipers. Put these on. Yeah, so when you have the expert mode, you wouldn't actually see the bolt. I'm not going to put that on yet. You wouldn't actually see the bolt. You'd have to know where the bolt is yourself in order to undo it. Is that everything for that end? I don't know. I'm always like missing some sort of bushing somewhere. But everything looks good. Okay, let's go from this end again and add on the brakes and stuff for this side. There we go. So we wouldn't even be able to see it from this angle. We'd have to go all the way around to these bolts here and then do it like that. So I've noticed we've actually put in the brakes in before the suspension. That's pretty interesting. Okay, suspension arm at the bottom, that'd be why. But I don't think we could have put that on until we had that brake bit in. Oh, can't even attach that one. There we go. There we go, that's interesting. Put that on. Like that. Yeah, I think I would have a huge amount of issues with the expert mode, but that's why it would be a challenge. It's not a challenge if I can do it easily. That's the whole point. Right, here we go. If there are any more other challenges, by the way, just whenever you think about it, not even just this video, whenever you think about it, leave a comment somewhere on some video and I'll try and see it. It's always, if you want to get my attention, it's always comment on the latest video. Because I normally, like, when I upload a video, I'll read the comments on that one until I upload the next video. And then I sort of just read the comments from the next video onwards. So, yeah, that's something to bear in mind. I think most YouTubers actually do it that way as well. Is that everything? Why can't we... Oh, that's why. Okay, now we can put that on. Right, I was wondering about that. I guess that's everything back on there then. Pretty cool. Yep. Okay, yeah, as I was saying, normally... How do we get back on? There we go. Normally, when I'm reading the comments, I read it from the latest video. So if you're commenting on a video from 2 months ago, chances are I'm not going to see it. It's just there are so many comments, it is impossible at this stage to actually just keep up with them. That's why I decide that I would just read the comments from the latest videos instead. I think that's everything. That seems to be everything. Everything else like that is the exhaust. That's the radiator. Yeah, I guess it's on to the engine then. Let's go back down. That's pretty good. We've got all of our wheels on already. Nice. And into here. Right, radiator I'm going to leave till later. Let's go with the engine block first. There we go. Alternator already. I don't know why we're putting that in already. I feel like that's too soon. Water pump. Even again, that feels like it's too soon. We need to start putting everything inside the engine first. Oh, we need to lift up the thing to put the crankshaft in. Oh, God. Up and down, up and down. Right, engine block, oh that's why, I need to do that. Okay, crankshaft is in, we won't do the oil filter yet, I feel like that's too soon. Right, focus on this bit here, I want to put in, not the crankshafts, do we have to put in the pistons first before, I guess we have to put the pistons in first. Right, back down again. Whew, we're doing good though, we're doing really good for time. It's only been around 10 minutes since we've started doing this next bit and putting everything back in. And we've already done the brakes and the suspension, so we're doing pretty good. Right, pistons in, I guess. Yep, pistons in now. Piston in, piston in, piston in. And one of the things that I was reading about with this game is apparently the whole... You know, like when we do the testing of the car, apparently, whether the car is damaged or not, the driving doesn't change. It's just bad 100% of the time. And I don't know if they're going to change that, but that would be a really cool thing. I think if the driving was actually changed depending on how bad of a condition the car is in, that makes sense to me. I just noticed that it's just consistently bad whether the car is 10% or 100% quality. There we go, spark plugs in. I feel like that's too early, but... The game is telling me to, and I'm going to listen to the game. Is there anything else on this side? Okay, that's going to start putting in the exhaust manifold. I want to put in, like, the oil pump and oil pan and stuff first. So let's actually just finish the bottom end of the engine before we start worrying about the exhaust. That's definitely the most important bit. Okay, move over. Come on, camera. I want to get into this bit here. Can I zoom in? Come on, let me in. I want to get into... Oh, God. Yeah, the camera's sometimes a bit... Let me in here. There we go. Put in all these bad boys. All these crankshaft bearing caps. 5 of them or 6 of them. Is it 1 per piston? I guess there's not one on the outside, so it's going to be 5, isn't it? There we go. 3. And four. Yeah, it was definitely five. Nicely done. And the other bit, which is the cross members in the way, but I can see it there. There we go. Yeah, the other thing about this is I'm pretty sure if you were rebuilding like the bottom end of your engine, you're not going to do it with it sitting in the car, because I'm pretty sure that the engine mounts on a car are going to attach to at least the main block. And it's going to be too awkward if you're putting in all this stuff whilst it's in the car. So I don't know if this game will ever allow us to like take the engine out on like a crane, and then we can just like have it here and we can just rebuild it. Like we'd have it on a floor or on a little table or something like that. That would be loads better. And then you can just like pop it back in. I think that'd be pretty cool. So that's all the bottom end done, I think, apart from the oil filter. We bung that in. Is that everything on the bottom? I guess that's all. Oh, we've got a mechanical fuel injection driver accessible from engine bay. Okay, we have to do the engine bay for that one. And I guess we'll do the exhaust in just a minute. So let's put this back down and do the rest of that bit on the top. The other thing, there are so many things I would love to see in this game. The other one is engine swaps. How cool would it be, right, if we had like a quarter mile strip and like we had this car in its like normal crappy form, and then we do the run, and then we sort of rebuild the car, and then we can get it in its like run with that engine all good condition, and then think like, do you know what, I want to stick a V8 in, and maybe using that crane idea I had earlier, lifting that out and then like making a new engine, just like have a table where you could just build an engine, and then you could just pop in a V8, maybe like stick a turbo on it if you could. Oh, that'd be awesome. I would really like that. Okay, so now we have the camshaft and the camshaft bearing, and then it's going to be onto the cylinder head, and that's going to be the whole main part of the engine actually built. That's pretty cool. There we go, onto that. Now that I'm starting to play this game more, I'm starting to familiarize myself more with engines, and I'm starting to get it. I'm starting to get it. I mean, I might not remember all the names, I might not remember everything completely, but I'm starting to get it. I'm starting to get it, and that's why I think this game is pretty cool. There we go, fuel filter is on. And when can we put the... Okay, well, let's just stick on the ignition coil, brake servo. They're nice and simple. We can bung those on. When are we going to put on the cylinder head? Do we have to put on these the cam gear and that first? Is that going to be inside? Oh, it's going to be inside. Okay. I tell you what I like. I really like the look of, like, the cam pulley things outside of the engine. Or at least... I think they have at least a clear cover on them. I'm not sure if they're, like, completely exposed. But it looks so cool. It looks so freaking cool. I think, Skyline engines have that. Isn't that... Oh, this is annoying. Now I've said Skyline engines, people are going to think, what is the engine code? Say the engine code, Lex. Is it RB26? Oh, God. Oh, man. RB24. It's an RB something. I tell you, it's all the details. People get really annoyed if you don't know all the details and things. I don't know why. I don't know why people get so into this thing. I mean, I get it. I'm supposed to know some of these names, but it's always like a detail that's like, yeah, I kind of know it. I know what I'm supposed to mean. If I was to read the name of the engine, I'd be like, yep, that's the engine for the Skyline R34, GTR, whatever. Or maybe actually, I think that was in most of the GTRs, wasn't it, that engine? I think I went all the way back to the R32. Oh, man. Okay, right, that bit's done. That's all done there. So I guess it's onto the exhaust now. Is there anything else that we can put on? There was that bit underneath, wasn't there? Yeah, there it is. Mechanical fuel injection. Oh, there we go. Now we have the mechanical fuel injection line things going in. And we also have our ignition distributor with our rotor arm and the cap. And there we go. Now is all of our ignition wires and everything plugged into the spark plugs. Awesome. Okay, now it's onto the exhaust then. Let's bung that on. Nice and simple. I tell you, it is nice and simple, but as soon as you're actually trying to do this in real life, it's going to be a case of, like, spending 2 hours undoing a bolt, getting absolutely smothered in oil and dirt, and that doesn't appeal to me, really. Right, exhaust. Here we go. We want to start from the engine. Can I go over there? Let me go over there. Oh, for God's sake. No! I don't want to start from here. I want to start over there. Do I have to... Oh, God. Right, let's just start from the back, then. Stick our rear muffler on. Stick the... If you would let me. There we go. Middle pipe. We've also got the drive shaft in the gearbox. I don't know why we haven't done that yet. Why are we doing the exhaust when we haven't done that yet? Okay, hang on. Let's go to... Not hood. I just want to... No. Engine. Give me engine. There we go. Engine. Right, let's actually just... Oh, we can attach that now. Okay, there we go. Right, let's stick on the flywheel. The clutch plate. Clutch pressure plate. There we go. All the cars in this game seem to be manual. Yeah, I said that I thought this was different in the automatic, and then afterwards I was like, hang on, they have like torque converters, they don't have clutches and stuff. So yeah, I get it. I get it. I get some of it. Fun fact, I've only driven an automatic once for about 10 minutes in my entire life. That's an interesting fact. Where's the drive shaft? Why can we never get this drive shaft on? There we go. Oh, hang on. We had it for a minute. There we go. Oh, there we go. Drive shaft on. That is a real pain. That is going to be a pain in expert mode in order to see all those bolts, because this camera thing is really fidgety with the drive shafts. Okay, that's in. And that should be all attaching. Hang on, let's go to the back. We have... Where is it? Oh, it goes under there. Oh, there we go. Now we can see it. It's attaching to that. That's pretty fancy. That's all good. What is new? What's good now? What do we have to put in? I can't see. Right, it's going to be something down at the front. Let's just move that back down. Maybe it's nothing underneath. Oh, lift obstructed. Make sure nothing is blocking its way. Huh? Oh, we were standing underneath. Oh, duh. Okay. That makes sense. Right, what else is there? Exhaust manifold cover? Ooh. I don't remember seeing this when we actually got this car. I can't remember seeing that. I guess it was just a big, flat, rusty panel or something, because everything gets rusty. I guess that makes sense why I didn't notice it. There we go. Pop that. Oh, come on. There we go. There. And there. Now we have the throttle. Pop that on there. And the radiator. What else is there? Let's just look at our inventory. Okay, we've got a few things. We've got some clips. That's going to be for the distributor cap, and that's going to be really annoying to put on. Hang on. Can I even see the clips from this angle? Can't see the clips. Oh, there we go. That's why I didn't have it in assemble mode. Duh. Okay, there we go. There's the clips there. What else do we have? Doors, batteries, radiator fans, serpentine belts, and starter. I think I already had a starter on there. I must have bought more than one. That was a mistake. Then serpentine belt. And radiator fan. Oh, this is awesome. This is awesome. And then the belt. And that's everything, isn't it? There's a starter here, but I'm pretty sure the starter's already on it. Didn't we put the starter on it? Starter. Oh, there he is. I thought we put... What did we put on then? We put on something that was around there. I thought we already put that on. Or maybe I attempted it and then... I don't know. I can't remember what I did. That's it. Battery, hood, doors. Oh, fantastic. There we go. Hood back on. Let's just lift that up, because it is amazing. Hang on. Why can't I... Oh, well, hang on. We want to put the doors in first. Assemble mode doors. And now the... Why can't I... Oh, there we go. Normal mode. Oh, look at that. Look at that. That is gleaming. What a beauty. Right, let's stick the battery in. Here we go. We want to... why will it... Oh, hang on. Car battery. There we go. Now we've got that in. Done. That's it done. We can now stick that in the center. Oh, look at that. There's the door. There's the other door. Let's sit inside. Oh, that is lovely. Everything is completely done. Why can't we shut the door? That's annoying. Right, there we go. Everything is done. Let's go and take this for a test drive where it's going to be exactly the same as before. In fact, let's go for the test path first. No oil, of course. Duh. Okay. Right, here we go. Let's take that off. Put some oil in. Why did I not remember that? That was dumb. Let's see. Just keep going. It sort of like stops me. It just stops me from like overfilling it, I feel. Because that's why it comes back up. Now we need to check. There it is. There's the dipstick. Nice. Perfectly centered. Brilliant. Let's take this over to the test path then. Oh, this is great. This is so great. And here we are, moving it forward for the front wheel brake test, rather. Here we go, press and hold brake, and everything should be 100. Ah, lovely. Lovely. Rear wheels? This looks great with the door shut, actually. Press and hold brake. 100 again, yeah, brilliant. I'm loving this. I would love to see, I don't think I've ever seen one of these cars in real life. I mean, I've seen a lot of classic cars and stuff at shows, but I don't think I've ever seen one of these in real life. This is great. This is absolutely great. I love this interior. Everything's at 100 again. And for the back, I mean, there's nothing on the diff. So when the diff has a number on when it's damaged, what does that mean exactly? I don't understand what that means exactly when the diff's got zero now, but it has numbers on the other test. Look at that. Absolutely wonderful. Brilliant. Fantastic. Right, let's take this over to the test track then, where we're going to see how terrible it handles. And here we are. And yeah, as I was saying earlier about looking at the updates and stuff that's coming up for this game, there is actually a quarter mile update that is planned, and I can't wait to see what sort of stuff we get with that. Oh, that was a good corner. Apart from the, as soon as you try to overcorrect, like, you steer slightly and the whole thing just completely spins out. Look at that, look. Oh my God, we've only just rebuilt this car and we've crashed it just like what we did with the last one. Thankfully, this game does not have any damage or anything, which is pretty good. Although I would like that. I would like it if we can crash the bodywork and then have to fix it all again. I think that would be pretty cool, but we don't have that. And, oh God. Why did that not count as the braking test? That just counted that brakes are terrible. Although they're not, actually. The game's driving thing is just terrible. And there we go. Everything is at 100%. Yeah, as I was saying, there is a quarter mile mod coming. I don't know whether that means we're going to get modifications like, I don't know, we could turbocharge different engines. There is actually one engine in this game that does have a turbocharger already. But it would be nice if we could, like, turbocharge this, or take this out and put a V8 in, turbocharge that. I don't know, change all the wheels. I'd like to change all the wheel size, tire sizes. Apparently there is, I'm starting to understand how custom wheels work, but these new Mercedes don't seem to offer the ability to have all the custom wheels yet, which is a shame. But I think that is something that is planned, so that'd be pretty cool. But there we go. Look at that. Absolutely gorgeous. Lovely. Let's just look at that one last time inside that engine bay. Nice, crisp, clean, fresh, brand new. Like, let's go here. Oh my God, we could sell this for over $100,000. That is amazing. Plus the restoration bonus, but I'm not going to sell this car. I'm not going to sell this because it's in absolutely perfect condition. In fact, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get my other car out, the other Mercedes that I did from the previous build, and we're going to look at them both together. And here we are. Here is that on the left. In fact, let's just stick this on the right lifter. Look at that. Both of these Mercedes right here. That is so awesome. This is the one that we've just done. All nice and gleaming. And here is the other one. Look at that. Everything is nice, shiny, new, and awesome. I am totally loving this. Yeah, I think that, I don't know. Maybe there's going to be some more videos on this game because there is more to see. There is some tuning stuff that we can do. I think later on that these are going to have more tuning options. I think I would like to see more, especially when that quarter mile update comes out, which I'm really looking forward to. Maybe we could do some engine swaps. I would love that. I would love that to be a thing. I remember in the earlier version of this, the 2014 version, there was like chip tuning and stuff like that. I think they're going to try and bring that back as well. There is still so much more coming for this game, and that is really exciting. I don't know if they're going to have a 2016 version or not, or whether this is going to sort of like just keep evolving. I don't know what's going to happen. But there we go, guys. That is it. If you have got all the way to the end of this video, I've just remembered that there are some more comments and questions. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to put them as text in the video because I am too dumb. And yeah, this is the, people have said in the past, you know, like when you leave like a special word at the end, people can skip to the end and leave that as a comment. That's cheating. That is lame that people do that, to be really quite honest with you. And yeah, that's the problem when I do this, is I thought, well, maybe I could like stagger some words throughout the video and then you could say them at the end so I know who's truly watched through them. But I always forget. And just like this, I was so deeply involved in doing this that I completely forgot about all the extra questions. So I'm going to put them in text, hidden in the video. So once you have all of your questions, you can then put them all together. So about by now, you would have seen all the questions, I guess. You can leave all the answers in one single comment in the comment section below. Do not actually have question, then answer. Just put one and answer. Two, answer. Three, answer. Four, answer. Five, answer. And those of you that actually do everything and answer all those questions, you will all have your name put into a hat or something. I'll make a way that I can randomize all of your names. And then I will draw two names because there are two winners from this video and there's going to be three winners from the other build video. So you can also enter for the full build for this car as well. Obviously, you had to do the same thing. Watch the video, answer the questions. And I will be announcing those sometime next week. I don't know if I'm going to do a special video announcing them or whether I will announce them at the start of just a random video. I don't know how that's going to work here. I'll figure it out. But there we go, guys. That is it. Thank you all very much for watching, and I will see you all next time
Goodbye.